to them you want them to get set up?
Yeah.
That wasn't clear.
The best time to write is...
Here. Now.
Oh, we're not.
Now.
Which one? That's
now.
Fine. That's fine.
Now.
The which best one? Time to write is here. The best place to write is now. All right, try again. The best time to write is...
You!
Now.
The best place to write is...
Here. You!
The best person to write is...
Here.
Here.
Us. We completely screwed this up. We're sorry, Internet.
Yeah, she did it on purpose. It's okay. Alright, our third and final, but definitely not least, performer. Someone I knew right from the beginning, even before writing nights was really a thing outside of my head. Every time I think of this person, I think of the poem that I wrote about a similar situation we both experienced. Once I got over the embarrassment of shitting outside, there was little else to bother me. The ass-puckering cold of a Michigan winter is nothing to scoff at, especially when I had to shit and all the stores were closed. Sometimes it was necessary to squat over a trash can, to let fly into a plastic bag, to squat outside of an abandoned house. Toilet paper was always a necessity. I pedaled 2 miles one way on my last major purchase to my college every morning. A week after graduation, I held an associate's degree in one hand and a pink slip in the other. It was my pride that lost both my job and my cats. The college computers were available all day except holidays and weekends after 5. I worked for less money than I was worth to afford a $50 a month storage unit where everything from my 2-bedroom apartment lived. The storage unit was my roof, my temple, my ninja den. It's where I slept when I had nowhere else. It was my pride that kept me there 10 months. My friend with benefits was a cancer survivor who offered me a roof a few times a week in exchange for a new feeling of acceptance. Anyone else I fucked them well in hopes they would ask me back. My pride wouldn't tell my family about where I lived. I only told the people near me, my best friend, my cancer survivor, a few online dates. I ate as much as I could whenever I had the opportunity because I didn't know when I'd have my next meal. Napkins were security blankets. Collecting napkins always ensured I'd have an opportunity to blow my nose or wipe my ass. Napkins, snotty, not shitty, ensured my coat extra insulation. Even now, I find myself collecting them in times of uncertainty. But outside air is 50% cleaner than inside air, so I rarely suffered more than a morning mucus clog. I didn't want to suffer a toothache alone, so I endured my best friend's roommate. This batshit insane schizo insisted Islam is about war and hate. The tiny knife stabbing me in the mouth was almost better company. Tylenol, Aleve, Advil didn't help. I was not too proud to use anal sex numbing rub on my tooth. When an acquaintance had pot to smoke, I took them up on the offer. I had a hard time saying no because it felt so good to forget. It was my pride that lost my meager source of income. My cancer survivor dumped me for getting too serious. My best friend lost his apartment and moved in with his baby mama. When you hit rock bottom, you have only up to go. I called my family. They helped me out of the storage unit with about 10% of my stuff. I lost my bed, my chairs, my tables, and a bit of my freedom. I lost my self-confidence and a lot of my pride. I gained a warm house and a roof over my head, but lost all sense of home.
Thank you. Yeah, a long way to the top, man.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Please welcome EPA 440. I'm not sure if that's all your name or if it's just EPA.
EPA.
EPA. Starring Zach Schroffel and someone else I don't know.
John Michael Vazner.
John yes, Michael Vazner. Yes. Okay. Woo!
Oh, yeah. This is like a new musical project. All these songs we wrote pretty much this summer. So. Yeah.
New shit?
All new stuff. But man, me and Az go back, dude. Back to the Enclave. Has anyone ever been there?
I drank Skylight there once.
Anymore.
No, that was the one in Willoughby.
Oh, yes.
They had a poetry night there, and that's where I started doing poetry.
This first one is called Space Races.
Thank you.
cold is it? I don't know that.
No.
No, it's not the one. Introduce the song.
Oh yeah, this one is about, let's see here, light pollution. And also, I don't know, we got too many parking lots, too much concrete. Something like that, yeah.
It's called Stars Tend to Light. This next song is called Cold as Ice. It's, I guess it's kind of about immigration.
Yeah, we wrote it before all this, what was it called, DACA?
Yeah. Zach sings it, so you'll have to bear with him. He's taking off his jacket.
I'm sorry.
Make himself. Okay.
Thank you.
recorded some like at the beginning of summer. So if you go to
theepa.bandcamp.com, you can check it out.
The EPA.
Oh, dude, we had a sign.
Right. Somewhere. Yeah, it's pretty easy.
You know which one it is, buddy.
The new one?
Yeah.
Oh, this one.
Mm-hmm.
This was like the first song we wrote, and then we like had to totally rewrite it.
It's about Donald Trump.
It's the president.
And he fired everybody and nobody works for the Canton anymore, so we had to totally rewrite the whole damn song. Believe it or not, there's
lines true. About every guy and like...
They're all gone now. They're all gone, so...
I don't know.
Except the important one.
Except the important one. Except the one we need to get rid of, you know?
We have an upright bass player that plays with us sometimes.
His name is Mark. He couldn't be here tonight. This one, I guess, about getting older. It's called No Younger. Maestro.
Thank you.
one more?
Yeah, we do. We have one more.
Oh, Anarchy Hood.
Anarchy Hood. That's the last one we have for tonight.
All right.
I can find it.
Do you remember $5 Hot and Ready Pizzas?
No. I don't know any of those old songs.
What's the guacamole song?
These are all new songs tonight.
The guacamole song was like 3 minutes.
They had it recorded tonight.
Oh, yeah. Hey, why don't you take a break? I guess I'll play an old one for Az.
Okay.
And then I'll,
sure.
I'll call it. Thank you. That's JB. Woo! We are the EPA. No one has an acoustic guitar here, right?
Unfortunately not.
This world is fucked up. Everybody knows it. Why should we bother to talk about it? See, we can talk about our politics, talk about war, or talk about dicks. Talk about oppression or drug obsession. We can talk about this bullshit recession. We can talk about our plans for the revolution day. But in the end, it doesn't matter anything we say. So let's talk about sail the seas on a herd of manatees. Let's talk about flying to Mars on a rocket ship made out of candy bars. See, our imagination is something that we really ought to mention. So let's sit right from debating before we forget how to pretend. I'm not saying we should give up on all that bullshit we believe in, but all this talking, never stopping, people are just only leaving.
She's a free spirit man.
guacamole, 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 guac. Alright, thank you.
Thank
you. Woo! Aiden Brown. He's a bass player in the Upchucks also. Probably.
Yeah, thanks for letting me go, thanks for letting me play tonight, guys. Like I said, the EPA.bandcamp.com. We recorded a few songs. They're up, and we're obviously trying to book some more. Also, there's a Facebook page or something. I think it's on the event page for this page. But
yep, it is linked.
Appreciate. I'm sorry we showed up late. I liked the robot one you had. You could totally put that in like a techno song.
Actually, it is a techno song.
Oh, I need to hear that.
It is called Save Yourself 7598. You can find it on Bandcamp. There are flyers with the web address, and you can also follow me at I am Daria Quinn on Twitter. If you actually want to get a hold of me, that's probably the best way to do it.
This?
Yes,
that.
All right, cool. I got it. Appreciate it.
All right.